Oh my god, the guy cooks too? We're gonna cook ourselves up a nice, fun little shepherd's pie. It's pretty economical and really sticks to your rib bones. What we're gonna need is about 1.5 pounds of ground meat. Your choice. I'm using ground beef. Some salt, some pepper, some Worcestershire sauce, a little bit of beef broth. You're gonna need about 1/2 cup of beef broth, but I cook up 1 cup and sometimes use a bit more, it depends. You're gonna need a nice sized onion, 2 sweet potatoes, yams, whatever you want to call them, 4 cloves of garlic, and about 6 medium-sized potatoes. Now there's going to be extra potatoes, so hopefully somebody's going to be hungry while this is in the oven and munch on some potatoes or something. You're also going to need about 2 cups frozen veggies. Works good for me. It's quite cheap and economical, and they're ready for you when you are. So I'm going to go chop all this stuff up, because watching people chop this kind of stuff up is pretty boring. We're going to be cutting the potatoes and everything into small chunks, because they will be mashed later. You're also going to need some margarine or butter for the mashing. And yeah, so get back to you soon. Actually, I'll be back to you in a snap. And we're back. Well, cut up the taters and put them all in there. We'll set them aside to boil, and while we're boiling, we'll saute up some of these onions, get them translucent. And then, I like to use a garlic press. This thing's great. Comes out this end, and I just slice it off as I squeeze it in. So after the onions are sauteed, we'll toss in the ground beef. Let it do its thing a little bit. Toss in some minced garlic, let it do its thing a bit, and toss in some beef broth. I'm going to saute in my extra virgin olive oil. Okay, so I'll toss a little salt in that water there. Helps it boil quicker. I like to keep my handles pointed in so they're not hanging over the edge. If you got kids especially, they won't knock it accidentally. Or if you even brush by it, you might knock it too. Everybody has their own thing to do. That's what I do, just to keep them knocking hot stuff down. Keep poking these once in a while. They're nowhere near ready yet. You don't want the yams too mushy though, okay? Give it some body. Oh, this game's screwing up my focus. Now, when your meat is browned, you're going to want to drain that grease. Ugh. Now, I'm going to pour about 1/2 of this, because this is a cup. So about 1/2 cup of beef broth, and you can put your frozen veggies in. Oh, there's still a... Yeah. And what we do now is mix all that up, let it cook for about 10 minutes on a low simmer. If you find that the juices are evaporating, that's when a little more of that will come in. Oh, I almost forgot. It's about now that you would also, if I can get this thing open, toss in your Worcestershire sauce. To taste, I like it. And well, I can't do my pepper mill while I'm holding this, so put a little bit of cracked pepper to taste. Taters are done. They actually cooked up pretty good. I'm going to drain them and separate them into separate pots. You do not want to mash them together. You'll see why later. Give this a stir every once in a while. Actually, I'm not a left-handed stirrer, but I'm a right-handed cameraman. It's time to smash some potatoes. Now, I'm not putting any milk. Normally I'd maybe put milk or something in your mashed potatoes. All I'm putting in here is some margarine so that you can get it a little bit on the mashed potato side, but give it, let it keep some body. Not chunks or anything, but body. You don't want it all cremated. I mean, not cremated. I don't even know what I'm talking about. You don't want it pureed or anything. And I'll get over and smash the other ones too, and then we'll get to it. Okay, our potatoes are smashed. Now is a good time to preheat your oven to 375. Come on, zoom, zoom. 375. Okay, now it's time for assembly. Use something slotted, like a spoon, or I've got a slotted spatula, just to let the juices stay. We'll pour some juices in later, but we don't really want it all at the bottom. Just pile it on in there. You're gonna make a nice even bottom. Now, let's make all this even, pack it down nicely. Now I like to take a little of that juice and just kind of get it all over. It's really good to sop it up in toast too. I might just do that for the rest. Okay, now, it's white tater time. Sit for about 5 minutes. Let it set itself up a bit, and then you'll see what I do for a bit of a twist. And here is the twist. It can be fixed up later, but for now, I'm just making the shape of what's to come. Oops. Yeah, that'll get the rough shape out. Grab yourself a spoon. And do some digging.